She came out of the grade one over at Keeneland, and she ran a good fourth that day against Rushing Falls. So we came in today with a lot of confidence, and we knew she'd handle the soft going just because it was soft that day at Keeneland as well. And she's just the type of filly, it seems, that since Kenny's put the blinkers on her, she's kind of turned the corner and gotten better and better.
Kenny's next daddy's
Yeah, I mean, it could be, you know, for a three-year-old filly like that to end her year with a grade two win like she did, and you got to look forward to her moving forward.
Kenny, she'd run some big races before, but how rewarding is it to see her come through with this one, moving off of, I thought, some tough trips in her most recent?
Yeah, well, the fact that she fell off form on us so bad last summer was a little concerning, and we really didn't know whether, and we couldn't find anything wrong with her was the weird thing. And then, you know, we had to make a tough decision back at Keeneland because it was either running the QE2, which we took a shot at, and she ran respectable, and when we felt like she was moving forward, and we were trying to get grade one type on her, and then there was another spot, I can't remember the name of the race that some others had run in that was a week later, and it would have been easier, but it was a bigger field. So today was it was great.
Do you have a handle on turf, dirt, or does it just not matter with her?
Well, I believe good horses run on anything. If you've seen me in the past, I'll switch them around and try a little of this and that. And you know, she's a light filly. She's really light bone. There's not a whole lot to her. And the dirt racing, I think, as they get older, it's a little more difficult. They need to be more powerful. And she's more refined, and, you know, we gave her a run over it, and she's done great.
What might be next for Princess Warrior?
We hope we get invited to the American Oaks again. Last year, we were second in this race with Daddy's Little Darling, and she went out there and won it. And, you know, I don't know what kind of competition we're going to hook out there, but we're going to plan on packing her up and going.
Could she be your next Daddy's Little Darling? Let's go.
Well, she's headed that way. You know, we got beat last year with Daddy's Little Darling in this race, so who's to say? I mean, does she need to find another level? Yeah, but she certainly did it. You know, she made this jump today, which we needed.
And both Daddy's Little Darling and this filly, both Ellis race, Kentucky Downs race. In fact, both ran in the Dueling Grounds of Oaks.
Yeah.
Daddy's Little Darling won it. This filly was second. But yeah. Just sort of talk about the path you take with these horses.
Well, I mean, anytime you can run in the straight three-year-old stake races and keep them in their age bracket, the better. And you really can't have any fear. I mean, there's not a lot of choices. There really aren't any dirt three-year-old filly races left. I ran today in the Cumley in New York, and that was a really good race for stronger than ever, but she, you know, she's not quite that good. So, fortunately we were here.
She paid a nice fat price to win. She was a shorter price in the morning line. Just, she was coming out of the grade one running big. Just so you thought about how you felt about her going into this race. And
that was a little bit odd. We were looking at the tote board scratching our head, 7-2 morning line, and she was 12-1 when we walked in the paddock. And my wife keeps a little wagering account open, and I turned over and said, you better bet a few more dollars because this is ridiculous. But, we don't bet a whole lot, but enough that when we see an opportunity.